Hello friends, welcome to CrackIt CSE, and in this series of database today we will be understanding the tuple relational calculus, that is TRC. So we have completed the relational algebra and SQL in the queries chapter, and now we are going to the third topic of the queries chapter, that is tuple relational calculus. So if you have not checked my previous videos, go and check the previous videos for the relational algebra and SQL. So before starting this video, I would like to request you all, please subscribe this channel if you are new here and press the notification icon so that you can get an update whenever I am uploading a new video. So now start with this particular topic. So what is TRC? TRC is nothing but the tuple relational calculus. This is a non-procedural query language. So unlike relational algebra was a procedural query language because everything goes by a defined procedure. But in tuple relational calculus, there is no such procedure that has been defined. That's why it is known as non-procedural query language. And the tuple relational calculus deals with the how to do. So it provides only description of the query, not the method to solve it. So the TRC is used to describe or to represent the particular statement into a query format. So we'll be understanding how, right? So and it explains what to do. It doesn't take care of how to do. So it deals with what exactly we need to do, but it does not provide any method or any technique to solve that particular query, right? So it doesn't deals with how to do, it deals with what to do. It uses the predicate calculus, first order logic and quantifiers. So we'll be using predicate calculus, first order logic and quantifiers. Now see, this is the syntax of the TRC. So what is the format of TRC query? T is nothing but set of tuples that has been obtained as a result, and these results are satisfying this particular query or this particular formula. So this T is a result set of tuples, those satisfies this particular formula. So T is what? T is tuple variable, and this PT is a formula over T. So PT is a formula. This PT will be using the predicate calculus, first order logic and quantifier. So we'll be using all these three things at the right hand place in this particular place. T will be the result set. Alright, now see, this is example. I'm having example where this is T and T belongs to stud. This stud is nothing but the student. So T belongs to student and T dot H is 20. So what is the meaning of this particular thing? It is saying that now we have to write the statement, that what will be the statement for this particular TRC query. So what it will be? It will be retrieve student whose age is more than 20. So this is just a description, as we already discussed that this provides the description only. So how we can write that? Retrieve the student whose age is greater than 20. So simply we can convert it into the statement form. Now there is one important thing as per for this particular T. As I told you, the T is a tuple variable. So tuple variable are of two types. One is bounded tuple variable and another one is free tuple variable. So the bounded tuple variable is having the limited scope. What is the meaning of limited scope? That we are using quantifiers like there exist and for all with all the tuples. So if we are using these quantifiers with the tuples, then it is known as bounded tuple variable, because the scope has been limited. Scope is bounded to this particular quantifier. So T1 and T2 are bounded because the scope is limited. And on the other hand, I am having a free tuple variable. What is free tuple variable? Free tuple variable is a variable which is not having any limited scope. So we can say that the T is free variable as scope is universal. So see that T belongs to student PT. There is no quantifier with this T. So T is behaving as a free variable whose scope is universal. Now, this is an example. There are two tables are given, enroll and course, with student ID and course ID in enroll, and course ID and instructor in course. And now we have to write a query for this particular statement. What is the statement? That retrieve student ID, enroll some course taught by course. So we have to write this particular statement in TRC queries. How I can write? See, this is the syntax I know. So first of all, go with the syntax. Write it as T. T is what? T will be the set of tuples. Now, I'm writing that T1 belongs to enroll. So T1 belongs to enroll, comma T2 belongs to course. Right? T1 belongs to enroll and T2 belongs to course. Now, see, I have to perform the join operation because we have to extract the instruction information from here, instructor information from here, and then we have to retrieve the student ID. And we know that there is a common factor which is CID, so we can perform the join operation. What is the condition of join operation? The normal join is having the default condition as equality. So we have to take both of these table and then we have to perform the joins. What is the condition of join? See, in the bracket I am writing out the condition. So what is the condition? That T1 dot CID has to be equal to T2 dot CID. That means the course ID has to be equal. That means equality condition is satisfied by this. Now what is the other condition? That the instructor has to be course. So we can write it as AND. We use this AND, the operator AND. And what is T2 dot instructor? T2 dot instructor, because we are having instructor in the T2 table. So T2 dot instructor has to be equal to course, right? So we have a T as a result where T1 belongs to enroll and T2 belongs to course, where T1 dot CID, that means enroll dot CID, is equal to T2 dot CID, that means course dot CID, and the T2 dot instructor is equals to course, right? So this is the query. Now we have to make sure that we are retrieving only the student. So I am writing another condition, and T is equals to T1 dot student ID. So this is the complete query. So in the end, it is important to write this particular statement because we have to retrieve only the student ID. That's why I'm writing T is equals to T1 dot SID. So this way we can write the queries in TRC format. Now let's try to understand some set operators, that how these set operators work in TRC. So I already explained you that R union S is equals to X, such that X belongs to R, or this is a operator of R, X belongs to S. Similarly, instruction intersection. In intersection, we have to take the common one. That means they have to belong to both of the table. That means X, such that X belongs to R. Here it is, and X belongs to S. So in union we are using OR. In intersection we are using AND. And in R minus S, we are having X as set of result, and X belongs to R, and S does not belongs to R. That means only the unique records of R will be represented. So that's how we can use these set operators in the TRC. Now let's discuss few more thing about this TRC. So what are these things? See, now this is, there is another example, that retrieve student ID, enrolled some course taught by course. See, we have to retrieve the student ID from enroll table, where some course taught by course and some course taught by Navate. So as I already explained you in the SQL also, we have to take care of this. And how we have to take care of this? And let me write the TRC query. How I can write? T as a set of result, then T1 belongs to enroll, comma, T2 belongs to course, right? So instead of T1 and T2, I can write that there exist some T1 which belongs to enroll, and here also I am writing there exist some T2 which belongs to course. So what is the meaning of there exist? That all the conditions does not need to satisfy, but whatever the T1 value I am taking, so there exists a T1 value in enroll table, because we are taking from enroll table. Here there exists some T2 value which belongs to this course table. Now we have to write down the equality condition, because we are performing the join operation. So what is that equality condition? T1.cid has to equal to T2.cid. So this is for the join operation. Now we have to take care of the instructor, and another condition, that is T2.instructor has to equal to course, and the T has to be equal to T1.sid. So this is the same thing we have written in the previous query. Now one important thing, so I am closing it here. Now see, this is one query, so let me put it in a bracket. Now again I have to make sure one thing, what is, now I have to take care of the second query. So this complete query is for the first one, that is course taught by course. Now I have to take care of the course taught by Namata. So we have to repeat this query once again with the change as instructor. How we can again write that there exists some T1 which belongs to enroll, there exists some T2 which belong to course. Now I have to put the condition that T1.cid has to equal to T2.cid, because performing the join operation, and T2.instructor, here instead of course it has to be Navate. And one more thing, that T has to be equal to T1.sid, because we have to retrieve only the student ID. So this complete query is the TRC query for this respective statement, right? So this is how we can write. But if we write this instructor is equal to Navate here in this first query itself, then it will be retrieving, it will be describing only those student IDs who enrolled for both of the course. But here we have to take care of the course and take care of the student ID enrolled in course, and we have to take care of, that means we have to know, we have to retrieve the student ID who enrolled for some course and some Navate course, where the instructor has to be different. But if I write it here only, that course and Navate, then it will be checking for only that student who enrolled for both, who enrolled for a course which has been taught by both of the instructor, which is not possible. That's why I'm writing it as a two query. Now next thing is, what is unsafe TRC query? So the TRC query with infinite set of tuples. If there is any infinite set of tuples in a result, then that kind of query are known as unsafe TRC query. Let's try to understand this with this example. So in this example, let I am talking about a sea or a ocean. So T, where T belongs to blue fish. So if I am mentioning that T belongs to blue fish, then if you consider a sea, in that particular sea we are having 1000 different kind of fishes, in which one is blue fish, and I am saying that T does not belong to B, and if T does not belong to blue fish, then means it can be any other fish. And apart from that fish, in oceans we are having some mammals like whale, shark, we are having some snakes, we are having other reptiles, and we are having so many kind of species. So is it possible to list these set of result? No, because there are infinite things apart from this blue fish in a sea. So this kind of query are treated as unsafe TRC query, because there is infinite set of tuples in the result. Because if we remove the bluefish from the sea, there are so many records which cannot be counted, because there are so many species and so many other stuff in the sea, right? Now let's try to discuss something about the expressive power of relational algebra and safe TRC queries. So the basic relational algebra queries expressive power is equivalent to the safe TRC queries expressive power. Why we are taking safe TRC queries here? Because it cannot, the unsafe TRC queries cannot be compared with relational algebra queries, because we are having limited stuff here, and the limited stuff cannot be compared with the limited stuff, right? So that's why we are comparing basic relational algebra queries with safe TRC queries. So the expressive power of both of the queries is equivalent. What is the basic relational algebra queries? The basic relational algebra queries are those queries which can be solved using projection, selection, cross product, set operator and union or divide. So if I can solve a particular query using these basic relational algebra operators, then we call it as a basic relational algebra queries. And where these queries fails? So the queries failed to express using basic algebra. What are those queries? The aggregate functions. In SQL we are having aggregate function, but we do not discuss those aggregate functions in relational algebra, because relational algebra is not able to express these aggregate functions like count, sum, average, minimum, maximum, etc. And one more thing which is not possible in relational algebra is ordering of records based on attribute values. But this ordering of records can be done in SQL by using the order by clause. So this is all about the tuple relational calculus or TRC in DBMS. So if you found this video useful, like this video, share it with your friends, comment your feedback in the comment section, because I am working hard for you guys. Making one video took hours. So if you appreciate the effort, it would be motivation for me so that I can work more hard for you guys. So subscribe this particular channel if you have not subscribed my channel. Share it with your friends. Thank you very much for watching. Keep supporting, keep learning. Have a great day.